Every queen deserves a place to get away. And I'm Lanita. I want to just kind of share a few things and other goals with you all. We're going to talk about my weight loss journey and just a little bit of everything, just kind of scrunched into this one little video. First and foremost, I want to just thank you all for visiting my channel and watching this video. Hopefully you like this content. If you do, go ahead and like this video, as well as go ahead and subscribe to the channel. All right, so let's go ahead and get into it. So pretty much I wanted to come to you all and just let you all know that we take that together can make this day a fabulous, amazing day. I'm gonna tell you how. First, I want you to praise God and say thank you for everything. Also, I want you to look in the mirror, and I want to also tell yourself that you love yourself, because that is the first and foremost thing that you should do every day, is just praise God and just thank Him from everything. You know, the birds are shining, or the birds aren't shining, but the sun is shining, the birds are flying, all that good stuff. So let's go ahead and get it. So I want you all to just kind of take a look at me. I don't know if you can see me, but I'm losing a lot. So far I've lost a look at this. Stomach is going down. I'm actually getting a waist, and hopefully I can get my booty get my butt straight. But I just wanted to tell you all that we all can do this together. It's hard, it's painful, but the first and foremost is just set yourself some goals. You know, what do you want to do? How do you want to do it? Do you want to run? Do you want to exercise? Do you want to start on your eating? Whatever those goals are, just do it. You know, I think we waste so much time just talking about it or just thinking about what we want to do. Like, for example, with me, I wanted to lose weight. I got tired of looking at myself. I've lost over 28 pounds so far. I went from a size 18, and I think I'm starting to fit into a size 14, 13, 14. I know I'm still soft, as you can see. But look at this, I could see the bones a little bit in my neck, and it feels so good. You know, I have more energy, I'm more happy, even though the kids keep getting on my nerves. But besides that, I feel more beautiful. I just feel more like myself, and it's worth it. You know, I feel like all I can do is lose weight, you know? All you can do is just lose weight. So it's hard. Right now I'm doing the keto lifestyle, and it's actually became a lifestyle. With that, I don't have I don't intake any sugar, no carbs. Well, I take less than 5% of carbs. You want 75% or 65% fat, 20 to 30% protein, and the rest 5% or lower carbs. So I look at my macros, I read them daily. People always look at me like, what is she doing? Well, everything I do, luncheons at work, tell them what I can't eat, and it's became so easy that I know what I can and can't eat. I'm gonna be honest with you. You see these two fingers right here, these hands, well, not two fingers, but these two hands. That's how much I probably exercise. I can count them on two hands. I haven't really exercised as much as I had hoped to do, but I need to get myself around that, because I do need to tone, and I just need to get my body right for the summer. In my mind, I want to get it right for the summer, you know? I have 44 pounds left to go to reach 165 pounds. There's no doubt in my mind that I can't do it. So I am wanting to come here to encourage you. I'm going to tell you that, guess what, girl? You can do it too. If I can do it, my lazy butt, you can do it too. Guess what? At work, I don't even take the elevator. I've made it an oath not to take the elevator. You see this? I have a Fitbit. That way I can count my steps daily and I make sure that I meet the 10,000 steps a day. That's like some of my personal goals. It's just little things that I want to make sure I do. When I'm at work, I think I get my most exercise because I'm consistently walking. Yes, I have a desk job, but I'm always up and about. I get my work done, but I can't stay seated. It's one of those things that I just can't do. Again, for everybody that knows me, I'm not sure if you reached my previous videos. Yes, I also do have ADHD, so sitting still for a long period of time is not going to cut it for me. So I utilize my steps a day. I guess the point that I want to make to you all is the fact that we are our worst enemies. We tell ourselves what we can and can't do. If you can't lose weight, guess what? You're right. If you can't get up and walk over there to pick up the remote control or just go outside, guess what? Yes, you're absolutely right. If you can't cut out carbs, you are absolutely right. Basically, it's whatever you put your mind to is what you can or cannot do. I've set a few goals. So far, I read two books. Two. And I'm about to work on my third book, which is Becoming by Michelle Obama. Right now, I want to seek inspiration, guidance. I feel like I'm going to be turning 34 soon, and I just want to uplift myself. That way I can uplift you all. Yes, I have not made a video in a long time. I know. I've been working on me. You know, I'm going to come back and forth until I get a lot of things together, but I want to make this video for you all. I mean, I'm not going to do a lot of editing. I'm just going to pretty much just post it and here you go. But I'm going to tell you that you can do it regardless of what he says or what she says. Do it for you. Do it for your kids. Do it because you want to make a life change, okay? Do it for you. I mean, what do you have to lose? Again, make this day or make today fabulous, because honey, you are fabulous. And whether you're thick, thin, black, white, Haitian, Creole, Jamaican, Chinese, Asian, Mexican, Hispanic, whatever you want to be, whoever you are, you can do it. So stand, put your foot down, and take it slow, one step at a time. All right, again, I have not exercised. I went from a size 18 to a 14. Yes, I'm still loose, and I'm gonna have a lot of loose skin. Look at this. But again, I'm making it. I'm doing it. I mean, oh my gosh, just do it. Just get your ass up and go. I mean, hopefully this is uplifted. I guess I'm just trying to be very honest with you all and just cut to the chase. If you don't do it now, then when? This started off as a New Year's resolution. And I know that they say that, oh, don't do New Year's resolutions and blase, blase. But I'm going to be honest with you. I'm glad I did. And I stuck to it. I've had a lot of temptations come my way. You know, at work, we have nothing but cakes and pies and sugar after sugar after sugar. You know, I've learned how to ask questions. And I've learned how to substitute. Yes, I love pasta. Guess what? There's a substitute for pasta. You can still enjoy that Alfredo, that spaghetti. Okay, there's shirataki noodles. Look it up. They're zucchini noodles. Hold on 1 second. Okay. Like I said, I'm not cutting anything out. So hopefully you are going to watch this in the raw. I don't have time to be cutting out because my kid's going to be waking up from napping in a little bit. You see this right here? This is a spiral life. Look, I got this from Amazon. And I think this was probably, it was less than $5. Again, spiral life. It is a spiral slicer. Okay, yes, I love noodles, but guess what? I can make my own out of vegetables. Who thought of that? Thank you. All right. I love fried chicken. Okay. Look at this. Okay. Where is the camera? Okay, there we go. Avocado oil. You can fry your chicken in avocado oil. A lot of people have air fryers. There are ways. Okay, there's substitutes is what I'm trying to tell you. Okay, if you like Pepsi, you have zero sugar Pepsi. You like Coca-Cola, you got zero sugar Coca-Cola. All right, I like coffee. There's sugar-free syrups that you can add to your coffee. I mean, there's things that you can do. Barbecue sauce. There's sugar-free barbecue sauce. Guess what? Two carbs. I mean, you have to do the research. At the end of the day, you don't have to lose the things that you love to eat. I love to eat. But you don't have to lose the flavor of things. Who said that? You ain't gotta live off a salad. You wanna know what I eat today? Hardee's. I had me a Hardee's thick burger. It was a two-layer burger with some bacon, some mayo, and cheese and a lettuce wrap. I substitute the bun, you guys, and guess what? I weigh 209 pounds, 209 from 238 pounds. I mean, all honestly, that's what it's about. You just have to make a lifestyle of it. What you tell yourself, it's what it's going to be. Do the research. Again, make today fabulous. Do something that you've always wanted to do. But just remember that you just have to do it. Stop talking about it. Get up. Get your ass out there. If you want to take a walk, it's nice. Go. All right. That's it for my video, you guys. So, again, I'm going to go ahead and post this. Thank you so much for joining me. More videos to come. My videos will be more about lifestyle and wellness now, and it's going to be a lot of things changing. You know, I'm going to give a lot of tips and tricks on a lot of lifestyle, whether it's dealing with money, organization, just all of that. So please stay tuned. Again, go ahead and like this channel, subscribe to it, because I'm going to be posting weekly. I'm also going to have an upcoming blog that's going to be coming up shortly. I'm still writing. I want to have some content before I can publish it. But yeah, you know, my dream has always wanted to be a coach. And I realized that I can be that. And I can do this through my YouTube. I've been doing a lot of studying. And I'm still studying. I don't know everything, but I'm reading. I'm educating myself one way or another. And guess what? You can too. Just got to do the research. All right, you guys. Love you. Thank you so much for joining me. And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Again, look at this. Oh, girl. You could be this fabulous too. Bye-bye.